Hi guys, it's me again, Wanda Fay. What I'm showing you here right now is, if I can, oh gosh, this is my, let's say, pretend I do a commercial for the Samsung Galaxy 3S, and that's my phone right here. So this phone is amazing phone. It's actually better than my computer in a lot of ways, my laptop. But for example, right now, I mean, I could just tell you so much about this phone. I'm just so thankful God led me to get this phone instead of actually the iPhone 4. He stopped me from getting it, the iPhone 4, and no offense against the iPhone 4. I'm sure the iPhone and Apple products are wonderful. But it just so happened to be that I got a check, a strong check in my spirit when I was going to go for the iPhone 4. And God stopped me, and I put it in his hands, and I'm going, okay, you know, I don't need this fancy phone. I don't feel right about getting the other one. And then God opened the door for me to get this Samsung Galaxy. I was wanting something better than what I used to have, previously have. So anyway, I'm going to try to make this phone is amazing. Besides the phone feature, the cell phone feature, it's just got so much on it. It's just wonderful. So for example, today I want to talk about some news. So I'm going to go to my Firefox, anyway, I mean, you can put all kinds of apps on here. Open up with my Firefox and go to some news over here. Top stories, Obama, we need to close Guantanamo Bay. That's from USA Today. You know, I can open that up and go to, well, you probably saw his TV speech today. I had it on mute because I just can't stand the rhetoric. And there's some political terms that I didn't know what rhetoric was when I started studying politics, but and I couldn't give you the definition of rhetoric, but it's something, I guess it's something you say over and over and over again, and you just kind of get tired of the rhetoric, and so I get tired of his rhetoric. Got tired of it quite early in his first term when he was on TV all the time, and Anyway, we don't see eye to eye, as you know, probably. Anyway, Obama seeks consensus on Syria, Wall Street Journal. Senator Rand Paul endorses Mark Sanford for Congress, USA Today. West Bank settler alleged Gaza militant killed in latest Israel-Palestinian violence. Well, you know, it's always Gaza is the one that attacks Israel, and then Israel retaliates, and then Israel's the one that gets blamed for everything. So, you know, that's messed up. What else do we have here? Kerry hails Arab shift on land swaps. Pyongyang glitters, but rest of North Korea still dark. Okay, so anyway, so you can go on here and go to your news feed, whatever you choose to use, through Google News or Bing News, whatever you prefer to go for your news. You can put your Twitter app on here, Facebook app, your email, it's got this little pocket thing. Pocket, I love Pocket, because Pocket, what you can do is you can go to a news story and then bring up the little thing on the bottom, and then you can save your news story to Pocket, and then you can share it with your Twitter followers or your Facebook friends. It's just wonderful. It just gives a concise, without all the hoopla of the story, and then you can repost it to your social media accounts. So, you know, it's just got everything on here. I got my tweet deck on here, LinkedIn, Instagram, which I don't use too much right now. Just all kinds. Daily Bible, CNN, which I don't use a lot. Play Store, which you can go to Play Store, and that's got all your apps for Android. You can go, it's got Pages Manager, which is for your pages for your Facebook pages. And I've got many Facebook pages that y'all, many of you don't know about yet. It's just, you know, I have these projects I work at, and I don't reveal everything all at once at this time. But if anybody wants to advertise with me, I would love for you to come on board, and just, I do things at a slow pace sometimes, but I try to share my heart and what I'm doing, and if you want to come aboard, and it can be affordable advertising with your links and or a display ad on one of my several pages. You can go to newsandprayer.com, and you might think it's a mess on there, but I've got so many links to so many things and good resources on there. I've got many pages that I'm working on. So I just keep working on all these things through the years while I slowly, as if I have, which normally I have a full-time job, so I can't, that's not my main thing, is what I do, is I do that on the side. I work at things slowly but surely. Finally doing my radio again, and I've got actually 4 radio talk show, half-hour talk shows on Blog Talk Radio. One of those is Wanda and the Word. If you want to go to Blog Talk Radio and click on Wanda and the Word in your search feature up there, you'll find my latest Bible study from Monday Night Bible Study last night. I'm trying to be consistent, but I'm not consistent. But I work at all of this. I work at it, and I'm still just trying to find my voice, which will be eventually, hopefully, of more substance and content in everything that I'm doing. And so, in the meantime, thank you for putting up with me, all of my viewers and listeners and my friends and followers on Twitter and Facebook, on YouTube. I've got 4 Twitter accounts, which I work at. And all this will be more, I'll be more effective and more efficient the more advertisers I have. So, and I don't reach out to get more Twitter followers. I let them just kind of add me. I really like just doing it, everything the natural way, even though maybe that's kind of stupid and some people may not agree with me that that's the best way to do it, but I don't have training in a lot of what I do, so I have to fumble around and try to find my voice here on YouTube. I'm getting, my radio shows are getting better. I'm getting more used to speaking on the radio. I began that first and then came over to YouTube because I knew I needed to be able to practice being in front of a camera and speaking without fear. So I'm still working at that. I'm still, believe it or not, on the shy side in a lot of areas. My writing is like, you know, I'm not going to put myself down, but I'm not that great of a writer, so I fumble around with that also on my blogs and everything I do. But what I do is I try to speak from my heart and then let God lead me and guide me in those things. And so, anyway, thank you so much for tuning in, and God bless you all. Keep praying for our country, for our troops, our world that we live in. There's a lot of people that are hurting out there that could use your prayers. And that's what I do, is that's my bottom line, is news and prayer. Even though you might not see everything I'm praying about, I'm praying because I hate to see hurting people. Not only do I want to see people saved and come to Jesus, but I don't like to see hurting people. So keep little children in your prayer. Keep people, you know, when you get in the car and you drive down the highway, pray over the highways and the byways. Pray over your own family, your own children. One prayer that I really like to pray, and is the blood of Jesus, the angels of God, over myself, my son, his wife, friends and family, and loved ones. Because the blood of Jesus is the blood of the Lamb, which Jesus shed his blood for us. And in the Old Testament, it talks about when the children of Israel were leaving Egypt, God told them to put the blood of the Lamb on the doorpost, because the angel of death was going to come through and deal with Pharaoh, because he wasn't letting the children of Israel go. He was keeping them in bondage to slavery. And so it's not that we, well, it's just a protective. If you speak, if you plead the blood of Jesus over, it's strong protectant, you might say. And the angels of God surround your loved ones, your children. Every day it's important to pray safety over your loved ones, okay? And I do that right now for you. I intercede for you that God would keep you and your loved one, all of us, safe in Jesus' name. And we plead the blood of Jesus and the angels of God over us all, over our country, over our troops, and that God will give you wisdom, provide every need, provide a job, income, whatever. The blessing of the Lord maketh rich, the Bible says, and he adds no sorrow to it. So whatever we're doing in life, we're seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, his way of doing things, and all these things shall be added unto us, unto you. And I'm always seeking, what do I love to do? And this is what I love to do. I love doing this. I love working at this and getting better at it. Even though sometimes I think I'm not getting any better at what I'm trying to do here. So, because I want it to be natural, and but I'm just going to keep working at things, and I encourage you to keep working at your dream, and God bless you and your family, your loved ones, in Jesus' name. And I'll talk to you later. Thank you. Bye-bye.